Hello.
Hello.
Happy Saturday. It's that time again. It's Mellow Del Tevling 3.
Yes. And what are you excited for this time?
Oh, I don't know, actually. Anders Bagge. Everybody is quite excited about him. Like, everyone is wondering what he's going to be about. He's going to be last on, so we've got a long time to wait, but I hope it's worth the wait. Okay, Kazi Opea. I can't get enough. Yes, she writes for K-pop.
Yeah, and she has had some Billboard success.
Yeah, she writes for BTS.
Let's see if she is a good enough singer.
She has actually sung a little bit in this presentation so far.
Yeah.
And it was quite good.
So the most important question here is it going to be up-tempo?
Yes, of course. Off-tempo. It's going to be very up-tempo. I'm excited for this one.
Strings? Let's see if I can find that here.
Oh, come on, really? This is a pastiche of another song.
Pastiche on.
A song called Issues by Julia Michaels. And she even said, I got issues, baby, we got issues. Okay, where's it going?
Not quite right pitch.
When you taste like that. I told you it was Robin! I told you he was gonna.
Yeah, I cut out that.
He cut out that bit for the video, but I promise you, you can insert that footage now of me saying it's gonna be like a Robin style.
But I think building up to this, it was more like my first.
Yeah.
It was not like what we thought in the end.
No, we thought it was gonna be more upbeat. Oh, I like the gloves.
Yeah, it's a very disco chorus.
Yeah.
Like disco pop. But what I don't get is if this is trying to be nostalgic or if it's trying to be very up to date. What do you think?
Sure. I think she's just doing her own thing, and I'm here for it.
Yeah, because it sounds like what's been popular for the last 10 years. Like
a little bit timeless. Ken. Could have been released 10 years ago, could have been released 2 hours ago, could have been released right now. I'm loving the rainbow visuals, the pastel rainbow. But it is very much like another song. Considering she's like mostly a songwriter, she's performing great. She's dancing, she's owning the stage, she's singing to the camera. That was great. That was really solid. Like, yeah, I know she's not going to be like the best vocalist in the world, but she did a lot more than a lot of seasoned performers have done.
Okay, now we're going for the next one.
It is Lancelot, right? The second word is pronounced slute. I said it in the guessing video, but in case you didn't see it, it's pronounced salute, and it means.
So it's not a rude song.
No, it means end, finish, complete. Like, it's put at the end of films. Salute. He was really surprised when they picked it because he'd forgotten he sent it in. There's instruments and a very nice embroidered shirt. Here for the shirt. But there's instruments, guitars and stuff.
What I was going to say before, I don't know how the system works with who makes it and not.
Oh, we were wrong.
Yeah, some Ted inspiration, I think. He has a band.
Ooh.
Yeah, he looked like he had a tenor voice.
I heard him speak, and yeah, I was like, yeah, he's got a tenor voice.
very Ted the Other Side inspired.
That's cute though, that Ted is living on.
Yeah.
Through new artists like this. He's only had 2 singles prior to this. Well, he has an electric guitar, so it's going to pick up.
His voice got stronger in the chorus than in the verse.
I like it.
I was a bit nervous at first, but...
No, I knew he was doing it a bit weaker, because he was doing it a bit like I was singing something earlier.
Yeah.
I don't actually remember what we said this one would sound like. Not like this. And the co-writer of the song is playing the acoustic guitar.
Ah, yeah.
So it's just him and the co-writer that wrote it, which is really nice. Very rare in Mellow, and I like that he's on stage as well.
But I wonder if this is going to be like everyone think it's very nice and unexpected and voted through, or if it's going to be like we're going to forget about it.
Well, let's put it this way. The last 2 years, there have been an indie or rocky or alternative act singing in Swedish, I think, that we have really liked,
yes,
and they haven't
Jacob
made it
Karlberg
through.
And Emil Assergård.
Oh, I'm outing. No.
Yeah, I think the people that have a band on stage, they feel like...
Because they can't play live, even though I can tell that, like, you can tell that they are playing what they're playing.
Yeah,
and I love that he's a guitarist.
Yeah, like, people are more here for the show than the actual appearance of a band.
Yeah. I have to say, though, I was very skeptical when I read that he was the son of a former artist or another artist and a famous goalkeeper. Hang on. No key change. I was very skeptical. I will admit that. And I thought it was going to be something completely different than he is. But I'm actually really impressed that he wrote this with one other person, that he can play guitar, that he's nailing this performance and this vocal. Like, I'm actually really impressed with him. Really impressed.
Tack.
Thank you. Bless him.
Yeah, I didn't play a lot, but it was something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, we didn't.
Lisa Miskovsky.
Ooh. Oh.
Tell him what it is.
She's worked with the Backstreet Boys.
Yeah, she's a girl with a hat and an electric guitar.
Oh, she's very Katie Tunstall.
Ah.
Yeah, but I think she's going to be a little rockier.
Why I think it's going to be double tempo is that she did a cover of a Ted the Other Side song. Which she made in double tempo version.
Oh, okay. If you haven't watched our guesses, I suggest now is a good moment to pause this video, go watch that video, which will be up there, and then come back to this video to see just how wrong we were.
We were very wrong about the first two.
Very wrong. Not super wrong about the first one, but...
No, we had something in there, and then we went and did something...
Yeah, I convinced myself, no.
Oh, a bit synthy. Is that a metro train?
Yep, that is the New York Metro.
She's
wrong about double tempo.
It's quite quick. She's singing with a very soft voice.
Yeah. It's happier than we thought it would be.
Her voice is a bit quiet in the mix, I think. Yeah, this is a nice song.
Yeah?
Like a nice radio song.
Yeah, for sure.
But I feel sorry for her that her voice is so far back in the mix.
This is the first time that we've had a complaint about the mix, though, isn't it?
A little pedal steel in the background. A little country. I like the train background.
I like the fact that the dancers aren't really dancing. Everyone's just kind of like walking on and off like they're in a metro station.
Let's see if I can play along with this.
Oh, skateboard guy isn't on a skateboard anymore. Wow, how is her backing singer walking in those heels? So these are all nice songs, but I'm calling it now. We haven't seen anything that would do even remotely well at Eurovision yet.
No.
These are nice songs, but...
Like last week.
Last week was the group of death, the heat of death.
Yeah.
The ring of fire. That was you didn't want to be in last week unless you were a big name.
I think this is exciting, though, because I think all of the...
Key change! I think you need to have the keyboard more on you. It's so far on me.
Will you see how it looks in the picture?
Yes, I know, but I just want you to be comfortable.
It's a good song.
Yeah, it's a solid song, but the fact that I'm talking about your comfort rather than... The song probably tells you that it's nice, but I won't be singing it tomorrow.
I like that it had a bit of guitar and a bit of synth. Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun. Tribe Friday. This one could be
popular by the sound of things.
Yeah. Yep, he's got an indie voice.
Oh,
I just spilled my drink down me. Okay, I have to make a confession that I've just really spilled my drink down me quite badly.
Oh. Shut me up.
Shut me up.
The Hives plus ABBA. Garage Schlager.
Well, I thought it was going to be Placebo and Youngblood, so...
No, this is...
I was wrong.
This is also going to be very colourful. I like that people are colourful.
Yes, definitely. And he says Tribe Friday well as well.
Oh yeah, it's a bit retro.
This is more indie than I took it for.
Yeah, we haven't played any drums. Oh. That was the bass, sorry. Shut me up.
Yeah, this is a lot more indie than I gave it credit for.
Yeah, and it was a lot more happy.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be something completely different.
Mumble metal.
Yeah.
This is very different for being metal.
Yeah, for sure. They've taken a lot of risks on a lot of different bands, though, this year, it feels like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't know how this is going to do.
No, me either.
But it's not so much competition as last time.
No. This is interesting because, again, we're four songs in. We've got three left. And I'm still like, this is fine. I just don't think it would work at Eurovision.
It's a bit more like the Kooks. Or
yeah, it's very Kooksian. So I'm sat really awkwardly because I'm trying to cover up a spill. I'm going to go change after this. So I'm sat like, don't look at me.
Oh, guitar solo.
He's the guitarist. Okay. I was trying to guess who was who. I knew that the guy in the skirt was the lead person.
Oh. A bit of a soft bridge.
I like the funky bass line.
Oh, I like that one.
That's really good. It's very Stevie Wonder.
I use that as Sajuk.
Sajuk, yeah.
Oh, so maybe instead of Abba and Hives, it was a combination of Stevie Wonder and the Kooks. No, it's Faith Kekemberfest.
I forgot that she's a nurse.
Yeah, she's a nurse. She's singing,
singing gospel. When I think of all the things.
Very colourful again.
Oh, come on. I hope this is good.
Freedom.
Come on, Faith.
I hope so. Starts like a piano ballad.
I don't see the love. Well, I mean, yes. I just see the wounds. I just feel the struggle here in me.
And can it be enough? It's a piano ballad, but it has a big sound, so I'm expecting something.
It's gonna build. She's too sparkly. Barefoot. That's three. Every barefoot person has gone straight through to the final so far.
It's very common this year to not start on tonic in the chorus, if we're being a bit music nerdy here. Oh, a beat. Maybe not quite that, but
close enough for jazz.
Again, a good song.
And instead of the dancers, she's got a gospel choir. Oh, one of the dancers is singing! Yeah! Is it? I've forgotten the dancer's name. But one of the dancers is also a singer then. That's awesome.
I like the staging. It took a nice turn. She sounds a bit strained in the voice. I feel like the chorus doesn't come as naturally to her as the other sections.
I agree.
It's hard to sing.
Anyone you know?
No, I don't recognize these people. She's still representing gospel, so I like this.
Epic voices.
Freedom.
Right? Isn't it the same kind of sentiment as voices, but way more epic?
Yeah. Still think the chorus could have been a bit more natural. It felt like they were trying too hard. But it was a good song.
I told you! Hoorah, 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 hoorah.
She's been in Mellow 8 times. And that's some kind of record, I think. Oh, yeah, I read something about the orange.
She's the sun? Thing.
She's a giant orange.
This is exactly what we said it was going to be. Yep. So far, so good.
Yeah, half temper.
No.
No.
She's wearing darks. That outfit didn't go where I thought it was going to.
Yeah, this is a bit self-empowerment as well.
Oh no. I'm so sorry. But she's just screaming.
She's had the same kind of song every year, so.
So we knew what it was going to be.
I don't know why she why she's still
trying. I like the outfit.
This.
This is very similar to what we said it was going to be.
Yeah.
Just no one screaming hoorah in the background, which I am disappointed about. Or aru.
It might be in the bridge, though.
Oh, yeah, maybe. I'm a bit... I just...
She's hugging people in the audience.
Yeah, and that kid just got very confused as to why her mum just got a big hug and a kiss. She's running around. She's kind of out of breath, which I understand because she's running around. But she's just screaming in the chorus. She's not really singing. It's just shouting.
But this is like how Swedish pop sounded 10 years ago. It's a bit like...
It sounds
like...
It just feels a bit like a karaoke version. I'm sorry.
Okay, what's going to happen now?
There's no hoorah, hoorah, hoorah.
And it's not so catchy, so I can't really play along with it. I can play along with the beat.
She's treating everybody like her best friend, which is cool. Key change? Yeah.
Key change.
I love the pink power suits. I'm here for the pink power suits.
Oh, there was a drum break when I was trying to play along.
Oh.
Tack förlåt och skål. That's a lot of reference.
Tack förlåt. Hurra! 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 She didn't do it at any point. No, I'm sorry. She's happy. And she's happy. There's no pressure on this last one, but there's a lot of pressure on this last one. Save the evening, Anders Bagge.
Yeah.
Save the evening. Ooh, child! That voice!
So he's not just judging other people for the sake of it. He knows
he
how to do it.
Sing.
Do you think it's going to be like a Coldplay BTS My Universe
yeah,
kind of thing?
Yeah, maybe.
At or least is it going to be a ballad?
It could be a ballad, but they've had a few ballads this heat, so I think it's going to be... They haven't had something big.
Except for Faith Kikamba.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what this is.
I'm nervous. But it's good nervous.
They have a lot of liver. A lot to live up to.
Oh. It's a 3-4.
It's a triplets song. I'm sitting near in my apple tree. There's a guiding light
shining down on me. I can see the dawn. Didn't call that.
Some pizzicato strings.
Oh. This isn't what I thought it would be at all, but I
this is
I
more
like
old-fashioned slugger.
This is good. What's the beat going to be?
Shut me up.
Ooh. Stadium rock. Yeah.
We are.
Yes.
Sorry. Bigger than the universe. Oh, it's like a paradise kind of.
I want to sit in an apple tree.
He has the whole earth in his apple tree.
Ooh.
Yeah. It's a very big song.
It's a
Forever
huge.
Forever Young.
Oh.
He had some problem with his monitoring during the rehearsal.
Oh, he didn't hit that note. I think he had to cut a note short.
Yeah.
I know that face because I've made that face on stage.
there's probably something wrong with his monitoring still.
Ooh.
But he still hits the notes.
Kids choir.
It couldn't have been anything else than this. It's a very big song. Big views in the background.
Yes, sing it, dude. I would have said girl, but I stopped myself.
The song didn't really go down. There was no breakdown. It was just continuing after the second chorus.
That is the only song tonight that I'm like, if we send that to Eurovision, I think it would do okay.
Yeah.
Genuinely. We're going to take a drink break.
See you in a bit.
See you in a bit. Here we go. The hard result.
So I was saying before when we took a break that I think that Lisa Miskovsky and Linda Bengtzing are going on to Andra Chansen and
semifinal.
And Anders Bagge and Faith Kakemba will make it to the final.
I'm hoping that Anders Bagge will just go straight through to the final because it was by far and away the best song of the night.
Showing all the artists?
Ooh, yeah, all of them. Multiple times. No, just once. No, we're still going.
Alice
yes! Look at him, he's crying! Oh, bless his sweetheart! Oh, I'm crying!
It was kind of obvious, though. Reaching for the stars!
I don't care, I'm crying, Johannes. I'm, like, legitimately crying. Because he's so emotional. He obviously didn't think he was going to get through. Everyone's having to,
so deserve this.
I'm so happy he got through because it means so much to him. Okay, right, decision was made. We'll see you in a bit. Vi har ett resultat igen. So they're going by age again, right?
Yeah.
So the kiddies, 3 to 9 year olds. Who do we think the kids liked? I think it depends. Lancelot. I'd say Lancelot. What?
Oh,
the kids like Cassiopeia. Who knew? It's colourful. It was bright. It was bubbly. I get it. And then Lancelot was second. Tia or Fem?
This might be Tribe Friday.
Lancelot. Oh no, they've gone for the Golden Oldies instead. The 45 to 59.
Decide this order?
It's gonna be whatever it makes the points look like. They like Lisa Miskovsky.
45 to 59
likes Lisa Miskovsky. Ooh, telephone votes. Number four.
Televotes for Lisa Miskovsky. So I was right about Freedom and Lisa Miskovsky. But Cassiopeia is doing better than Linda Bengtzing.
Yeah, she's doing better than I thought she was. Ooh, 60 to 74.
Lisa Miskovsky. Yes.
So she's going to go through to the final now.
I like her. I like her song.
Oof.
I feel sorry for Tribe Friday. They were good at what they were doing, but people weren't ready for it here.
No, I agree. And that's going to be your top three, Lisa Miskovsky, Faith Kakembo, Cassiopeia, in some order.
I'm going to say something here,
oh,
because we haven't really decided this, but you can help us decide. Mm. What do you want us to do in the semifinal, and what do you want us to do in the final?
Yeah, because we won't be able to guess because we know what they're gonna sound like. There's very small changes that are made, but like they're tiny, tiny little staging changes. So
obviously we're gonna react in some way, but if you have a suggestion,
what the cover version of a song, let us know in the comments down below and subscribe if you haven't already.
Now it's our age group.
Yes. Oh, okay, it's the last one.
Yeah. Faith Kakemba.
Yay!
Oh, she went to semi.
What? They're shocked. They're trying not to be shocked. But they must have given her the 60... What? What? So they must have given like Lisa Miskovsky like 1 point.
Fifth camera.
What? That could be. I'm gonna have to watch this back. Before this ends, I think we're gonna have to rewind back through it to see what happened. In fact, can we rewind back through it now?
Yeah, we can. So we watched it back now, and it turns out that Lisa Miskovsky got one point
from the 16 to 29 year olds. Yep. I was so shocked that I made you watch the whole voting back so that we could actually track it.
Yeah, because she got so many 12s. It didn't seem fair.
But it's literally showing that just one age group not vibing with your song changes everything.
But I think the age group below us, 16 to 29, they haven't grown up with Lisa Miskovsky's music.
Towards the lower end of that, yes, I'd agree. Towards the upper end of it, they may have skewed it a bit, but...
But it feels more like nostalgia to them than anything else.
Yeah. And do you think a lot of them will be in gospel choirs and they will have appreciated it? Or do you think it's more to do with the social message of Faith Kikembo's song?
I just think people like that kind of song. Like people like the Mamas a lot. And people like Voices. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I still stand by that it sounds like an evolution of Voices. But I do like the song. And the whole point is that we wanted it to go through, right?
Yeah.
Or well, I did.
It's the one we remember.
Freedom.
And we don't really remember any song.
I don't remember Lisa Miskovsky's song at all, other than she had a skateboarder and people were walking in and out and her backing singer had really big heels. I remember the staging. I don't remember the song. But
I think her song is one I'm going to listen to more than Faith Kikembo.
Agreed. Faith Kikembo got through. Lisa Miskovsky got 1 point from the 16 to 29-year-olds, and that is why she didn't get through.
So I was right.
So worried.
I was right. Faith Kikembo and Anders Bagge and her. I was wrong about Cassiopeia.
Yeah.
She went through instead of Linda Bengtzing, and I think that was...
It was A, deceptive. I think it was the better choice, but B... I remember her song more than I remember the others, but I also can't remember it. You know what I mean? I remember the staging. I remember that it was a really solid start. And if I'm being honest, it set me up for a Deltävling that didn't really come.
Yeah.
After last week being just good song after good song after good song after good song, I feel like some people went out last week that if they'd have been in this heat... 100% would have gone through. All three of them.
Yeah.
So we'll be back later on this week with a guessing video for the last Deltävling.
Yes.
And there's a few artists in there that I think we're looking forward to. My pre-mellow favorite is in there.
Which one?
Lilla Sister.
Yes, there's going to be some...
That's my kind of music. And you're excited for next week because...
Medina.
Okay, we need to finish this. How are we going to finish this?
New Stopavi! I have no keyboard to drop this time, so
it's already dropped, so we'll just kick it. And destroy the whole table.
That was harder than
that was violent.